If you're looking to find out what density is all about, its formula, and how to solve density-related problems, you've come to the right video. Hi, welcome to ChemSimplified. I'm Dr. K, and in this video, we'll go through how to calculate density using two examples. In one of the examples, we will also touch on measuring volume through water displacement. So stick around until the end if you're interested in that. First off, here's the formula for density. It's pretty straightforward actually. It's mass divided by volume. Normally, density of solid is expressed in grams per cm cube, while for liquid it's grams per ml. These two units are actually the same numerically because 1 cm cube is actually equals to 1 ml. It's just that when you measure the volume of solid, it's calculated in units of length cube, meaning like cm cube, meter cube, whereas for liquid, it's usually measured in milliliter, so that's why there's a difference in the unit for the density of solid and liquid. For density of gas, it's usually expressed in grams per liter. That's because gas is less dense than liquid, so if the density of gas is also reported in grams per ml, the value would be very very small, which is not very convenient to write. So that's why it's normally reported in grams over liter. Okay, so now that we know the formula, let's talk about density. What are some of the examples of density that are being applied in our daily lives? Well, the first that I can think of is iceberg. We see frozen fresh water floating in seawater. Now, the frozen fresh water has lower density than seawater, and that's why it floats. Another one that would be familiar would be ice soda. We have ice floating in our soda. The reason the ice floats is because the ice has lower density than soda water. The third one, which may not seem related to density, is vaccine or medicine. So what does density have to do with needles and vaccine? Think about this. Whenever you get a jab for something, right? A vaccine for hepatitis or a vaccine for tetanus, I don't know, just something. Have you ever seen the doctor or the nurse weigh out the mass of the vaccine? No, right? It's always measured using a syringe, correct? Well, that's because it's easier to measure the volume of a liquid than to measure the mass of a liquid. So that's why the vaccine is always measured using the syringe. So how do we know how much volume to draw out? Well, it can be easily calculated when the density of the vaccine is known. In fact, let's go ahead and do an example. Let's assume that we need to administer 1.2 grams of vaccine X. Knowing that vaccine X has a density of 0.785 grams per ml at 20 degrees Celsius, we can calculate the volume that we can easily measure out using the syringe. So let's start with the formula for density, which is mass over volume. But since we want to calculate volume, let's rewrite the formula a little bit, rearrange it, so I bring volume up, so then it becomes volume equals mass over density. Now let's plug in the values that we have. We have 1.2 grams for the mass, and 0.785 grams per ml for the density, and dividing these two numbers will give us 1.5, and if we cross out the unit, it will leave us with ml. So the volume is 1.5 ml. So we can easily draw out the volume of 1.5 ml using syringe. Much easier than if we were to measure out 1.2 grams. Make sense? This is a really direct, simple problem related to density. Now let's look at another density-related problem that's a little bit more difficult. So we have a task here, which is to figure out whether the crown is made out of pure gold or not. And we're given two masses, the mass of the crown in the air, that's 4258 grams, and the mass of the crown in water, that's 3926 grams. And then we're also given two densities for our reference, one is for gold, and the other one is density of water. And we're given the look of the crown. So it looks like a gold crown, and we're trying to figure out whether that's pure gold or not. So to figure out whether it's pure gold or not, we basically have to figure out the density of the crown. And then we compare it with the density of gold. So if we figure out that the density of crown is somewhere near really close to 19.31, we can conclude that the crown is made out of pure gold, right? So you might be wondering, why are there two masses given for the crown? What's the purpose of it? Well, take a look at the crown. Will you be able to measure the crown's volume? I mean, it's not a perfectly shaped cone or a rectangle. So we can't apply a formula to come up with the volume. So what we're going to have to do is we're going to displace water and measure its volume that way. So we're going to use Archimedes' principle to figure out the volume of our crown. So we start off by measuring the mass of the crown in the air, and that's 4258 grams. So what we do is then we fill up a tank all the way up to the spout with water, and then we submerge the crown. So once we submerge the crown, some water will be displaced out. That means we can use the mass of the displaced water to calculate the volume of the crown. This is sometimes referred to as volume by water displacement. It's a popular method to figure out the density of odd-shaped object. So let's see how we're going to figure out the volume of our crown using this way. We start off by subtracting the two masses that were given. That will help us figure out the mass of the water displaced. So the mass of the crown in the air is 4258 minus the mass of the crown in water, which is 3926. Subtracting these two numbers will give us 332 grams. So that is the mass of the water that is displaced out. Now, since we know the mass of the water and the question gave us the density of water, we can easily figure out the volume of the water that's displaced. So volume is equals to mass over density. We just simply rewrite the formula of density. So plugging these numbers will give us 332 ml. Since the water that is displaced out is due to the submerged crown, we can conclude by saying that the volume of the crown is also the same as the volume of the water that is displaced out, which is 332 cm³. Notice I just changed the unit ml to cm³ because I'm now talking about the crown. Crown is a solid object. So I'm using the appropriate unit for solid. So now that we have found the volume of our crown and we know the mass of our crown, the one that's in the air, we can apply the density formula and we can figure out what's the density of the crown. So we take the mass, which is 4258 grams, divide by 332 cm³, and that will give us 12.8 grams per cm³. Now compare the density of the crown that we just calculated with the density of gold. Gold is 19.31. What do you think? Is the crown made out of pure gold? Sadly, no. So it looks like the crown is not made out of pure gold. So these are two examples to show you how density can be used in real life application. Just to recap, density is mass divided by volume. Hope you find this video helpful. Do subscribe so you won't miss out on new videos. Head over to ChemSimplified.com for practice questions. I'll post the blog link in the description box below. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.